sharp grades. And we're going to be working with the local authority around the integrated commissioning approach around sharp grades. But also what we want to consider is actually the model. And at the moment, because we're registered under the regulated care which requires 24/7 nursing, we've actually been speaking with CQC about how we move to a different regulated activity, which is accommodation with care. And this will allow us to have more flexibility in the workforce and actually provide care at the point of need, not just having a registered nurse there 24/7. And we'll be working with our rural partners around how we flexibly use our workforce then to support those individuals in a very person-centred way. I'm pleased to be in that position that I'm able to tell members today that we're able to reopen on the 5th of April, but we do need to go through a process in terms of working with colleagues to ensure that we've got the right level of care going forward and that it's in line with the transforming care agenda. Any questions?
Thank you. Any questions? Wendy?
Thank you very much. And it's good to know that you've been able to make some progress on the staffing matter. Granted that there is this overarching problem around the uncertainty of what the provision is going to look like in the future, what is the kind of time scale you're looking at in order to resolve that?
I think that's in terms of working with the local authority. We haven't got any specific time frames in terms of when that new model of care will be agreed and when we're implementing it, but we're looking at moving the first stage of that is around moving the regulated activity element, and we're looking at doing that within the next 3 to 6 months.
That's great. So I'm not quite sure if that means there's a little bit of a hold up in terms of setting up processes to work together with the local authority, or whether it's just one of those things that takes time.
I think we've been in dialogue with both the local authority and the CCG around these new models of care, and what we need to do is actually then agree what that new model of care is going to look like so we can forward and move forward on the changes that will be for Wirral. There is a national agenda out there that is actually quite prescriptive around what that new model of care will look like. What we need to do is think about how we deliver that from a place-based perspective and what that means to the residents of Wirral and for those people that are accessing learning disability services, not just the short breaks element, but how we look at that in the wider context.
Okay, thank you. Treena on their mic and Christina, please.
Hi, Suzanne. My question is related to the staff. Obviously, there was lots of uncertainty with the staff. I mean, I was approached by email from a member of staff who actually worked at Thorn Heys at the time. She's now been capacity since got another job elsewhere. Now you're reopening on the 5th of April. How did you get the staff? I mean, have you got the full staff now? Have you asked the staff that have previously been let go? Would they like to be redeployed back to Thorn Heys? I mean, what was the situation?
It's a mixture of all of those. What we've done in the past, we secured some temporary staff who we've now made permanent. We've also gone out to adverts and got some newly qualified staff, and we've also done some internal staff moves as well. What we've done as well is to make the job more attractive is what we call advertise it as a peripatetic post. So that in the new model of care going forward, that we'll be able to transition those staff into the new model of care so they don't feel that they're just restricted to provision of respite and short breaks. So it's actually giving them greater career opportunities.
Thank you. Thank you, Jo. Thank you, Suzanne, for that report. When you talk about a new model of care, are you modelling down? Can we have an assurance that you're not going to diminish the care that was being presented before you had the problems? So you're not diminishing the level of care that you're giving in order to reopen?
No, it's very much around at the moment we're reopening as we were providing care back in January. So it's the same level of care. We've worked with the carers have been rotated back in so that they will get their short break sooner rather than later. The transformation element of it talks very much about a different model of care where we're providing very individual support, looking at providing crisis provision and more support in the community, so there's less reliance on beds. But again, that's very much detailed in the national agenda called Transforming Care.
Christina? Suzanne, thanks very much for that. Pleased to hear that it's opening. I'm a little bit concerned though when you say changing the nature, because that presumably means that either the people who are there now, or will be there now, don't need the nursing care, or you're going to change the people who go there. And if it's within the community, the anxieties I've always been having with parents and carers is that it's not like going away. And for the person who's doing it, it's not like the weekend away. Relatives of mine who've been on this bike, it was like a weekend away from them. So why would that change? Why would they want to be somewhere else?